Exponential of log psi naught, and here we will have exponential of minus m omega over h bar, so it will become 2 h bar x square, and plus a constant. And now this will be psi naught, and this is equal to this e of this, and then multiplied e of a constant. So e of a constant will also be a constant, and let me write that constant is a naught, and e to the power minus m omega over 2 h bar x square. So we have found the ground state wave function psi naught of x is actually equal to a naught e to the power minus m omega 2 h bar x square. Now here this wave function will be a function, a wave function which will be the lowest possible energy state. We will find the normalization constant, that what's the value of a naught. Once we find this value, then we will have our normalizable wave function. So let's calculate that what's the value of a naught. So the wave function, that the ground state wave function that we have derived, is psi naught of x equals a naught e to the power minus m omega over 2 h bar n x square. The normalization constant a naught is supposed to be determined. So we will have to normalize this wave function. The normalization condition for any wave function is psi mod square dx should be equal to 1. And this implies from minus infinity to plus infinity, psi naught mod square dx should be equal to 1. And this implies that minus infinity to plus infinity, a naught square, as we are having no iota involved, so we will simply square it, minus m omega over h bar, because 2 will cancel, and x square dx, and this is supposed to be equal to 1. Now by utilizing the integration, that from minus in from 0 to infinity x to the power 2n e to the power minus x square over a square dx is equal to pi, and 2n whole factorial divide by n factorial a over 2n plus 1. So it is also this kind of integral. Now the first difference between this and this is of the limits. This is from minus infinity to plus infinity, and this one is from 0 to infinity. Now if I look here, this is an even integral, so I can replace the minus infinity for even integral, the minus infinity to plus infinity, and any even function f of x dx is equal to 2 times from 0 to infinity, and f of x dx. So I will have to convert this one from 0 to infinity, and 2 times a naught square e to the power minus m omega over h bar x square. So this is equal to 2 a naught square 0 to infinity, and e to the power minus x square over h bar m omega. So when this will go up, it will be m omega or h bar dx. Now here in our integral compared to this one, here n is equal to 0 because we don't have any x here. So the x power n is equal to 0, while a is equal, if I look here, then a is equal to h bar over m omega. A square is equal to this. So a square equals h bar over m omega. This implies a equals h bar over m omega 1 over 2. So this integral will give us, so I can write, this implies 2 a naught square, and then it will be pi, and then 2 and n is equal to 0, so it will be 0, factorial is 1, 0 factorial is 1, so this whole will become 1, and then a by 2, so a is equal to h bar over m omega square root, this is the value of a, divided by 2, and whole to the power 2 into 0, 0 and 1. So we got that this is equal to 2, and now this 2 is canceling with this 2, because it is having power 1, it is having power 1, so we are left only with h bar m omega square root, and this pi is also in square root, so we are having a naught square, and then pi h bar over m omega square root is equal to 1, and this is equal, this implies that a naught is equal to, this will reverse m omega or pi h bar, 1 over 2 is this one, and 1 will come, 1 over 2 come from here, so we will have m omega over pi h bar 1 over 4. So this implies that our wave function psi naught of x is equal to m omega over pi h bar 1 over 4 and e to the power minus m omega over 2 h bar x squared. So we got the lowest state of the harmonic oscillator or the ground state of the harmonic oscillator. Now as we have found the ground state, now we can find all other states by applying the raising operator on this one. What about the energy of this level E naught, psi naught being the ground state? So what will be the energy associated with this ground state? We can write is H of psi naught is equal to E naught psi naught. So now the H is, we have derived earlier, if I write in terms of H omega, h bar omega, and then I write a plus a minus, then I will have to write plus here and half here. This is the h from previous derivations, and then psi naught is equal e naught psi naught, and now just apply this one, we will have a plus a minus psi naught, and then h bar omega with this one plus half h bar omega and psi naught is equal to e naught psi naught. So what about this one? When a minus operates on psi naught, we know that this will go to zero. So we will have zero here, and from here I can write that half h bar omega psi naught is equal to e naught psi naught. This implies that the ground state energy is actually equal to half h bar omega. Now this is quite astonishing that in classical harmonic oscillator, the zero point energy or the zero state energy we have is zero. When the harmonic oscillator is not moving, then we are having zero energy, and here we are having the ground state energy or the zero state energy here is half h bar omega. This means that quantum mechanical particle will not come to rest. Its zero energy will be equal to this much, half h bar omega. Now from our previous calculation, we know that when psi was having the energy E and A plus psi was having the energy with an increment of h bar omega. Similarly, A plus psi was having the energy is 2 h bar omega. So if I operate this way, a plus n times on psi, then it will give me the energy is e n h bar omega. So if this is the ground state psi naught, then it will be e naught. When a plus will operate on psi naught, it will give another state but with energy e naught plus h bar omega. Now the next state will be, I can write here that e naught is, so we will have e naught here and then e naught here. So the nth state energy, if I write, is En, and this will be equal to E naught plus N H bar omega. Now the E naught we have already derived that this is half H bar omega, then plus N and H bar omega. So this is equal, if I take this h bar omega is common, then n plus half and h bar omega. So I can write that the nth energy will be is a multiple of n plus half h bar omega. Now we have found psi naught, and then this psi naught will go to psi 1 and psi 2 and psi 3, psi 4 and so on until it reach psi n. Because there is no limit on psi n, so the psi n will be determined, psi n of x will be equal to a n. So we will write a plus n times on psi naught of x, but a psi naught of x is having its constant, then that constant will be utilized with psi naught, but this will have its own constant, like it will have a n. So when it is psi naught, this is a naught psi naught. This psi naught, we determined this a naught earlier. Now when it will be psi 1, this will be a 1 and this will be psi naught, but with its constant of normalization with it. So that constant will multiply with this constant in order to make the constant of normalization for psi 1, similarly for psi 2 and psi 3. So this way we can find all possible energies and all possible wave functions. This is for the nth state and this is also for the nth state, the energy. So this way we can calculate all the states.